That's a little tease, I know. We'll get into that another day. So this article that Mike the Cop brought in, Sirius likely to relaunch Opie and Anthony show. This is from a year and a half ago. Bill Burr, everyone, has entered the program. Entered the studio. So the article goes, don't be surprised when WNAW exiles Opie and Anthony pop up more and more as June approaches and they prepare to return to the radio. There are no accidents in the promotion game at which ONA excel. Also, don't be surprised if they sign with Sirius Satellite Radio, meaning fans would have to buy a Sirius receiver and pay $12.95 a month. Opie and Anthony have been off the air since August 2002 when two listeners were arrested for having sex in St. Pat's Cathedral as part of ONA's Sex for Sam contest. NAW station manager and program director were fired, and the station soon dumped the whole hot talk format ONA had been anchoring. The two have always implied that they wonder what the big deal was, and they say so again in the new FHM magazine. They also used the interview to reinforce their irreverence, sniping at WNEW's parent company, Infinity, and complaining because Infinity has been keeping them off the air. Of course, Infinity has also been paying them millions, but they have always painted themselves and their fans as proudly rebellious targets of a disapproving and humorless world, and they're not about to abandon that position. As for where they will surface in June, three major factors suggest Sirius Satellite Radio.
Oh, three major factors?
First, Satellite has no content rules.
Yes.
Second, former NAW program director Jeremy Coleman, a big ONA supporter, now works at Sirius.
Ah, well.
Still works there.
Another clue.
Still supports us. Still loves us, by the way. Listens every day. I saw him on the street recently. He goes, I listen to you guys every day. You guys are sounding better than ever. Thank you, Jeremy. Third, Sirius trails rival XM and wants splashy, high-profile programming to close the gap.
Mm-hmm.
100 channels is nice, but that's not what sells, says Tom Taylor, editor of the trade magazine Inside Radio. We've seen from cable TV that what sells are specific things people really want that they can't get anywhere else. Opie and Anthony would likely cost millions.
Millions, Opie.
But if they brought Sirius 20,000 new subscribers, a small fraction of their daily audience when they were syndicated out of NAW, that alone would mean $3.1 million a year in subscription revenue, exclusive of advertising. Asked if Sirius would be interested in ONA, acknowledging that they are still under contract to Infinity, Sirius Vice President of Programming Jay Clark, who's still over there, by the way, says, and I quote,
"Yes,
you never know. They're very talented guys."
Thank you.
"Who are restricted by the rules in commercial radio."
Thank you, Jay.
ONA would have to make decisions, too. They would have a similar audience. They would have a smaller audience. Also, part of their shtick on NAW was getting around content rules with winks and code words. Sometimes graphic is less interesting than suggestive.
You know, you could replace Anthony, Opie and Anthony, with Howard Stern, and that is an article from a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, I know.
Like, it's the same article.
I know. But if it worked out, ONA could say they were to satellite radio what MTV was to cable television.
And it did. And we are.
We are here first.
Annoying. Oh, isn't that what MTV was? No. Yeah.
And that's about it.
Hey, see? We made it.
There you go.
Why does this mic smell like Lysol? Did you guys already have some whore in here?
No, I think the mics are all Lysol'd first thing in the morning.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
Infected.
Yeah,
very clean.
Okay. Don't want to get sick, you know? Again.
Bill Burr, how are you?
Oh, I'm fantastic.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
How you been on the road?
Yeah, I was down in Miami doing the South Beach
Miami
Comedy Festival.
How was that?
Fucking unbelievable.
Nice broads down there.
It was ridiculous. I think I was actually.
That's all you hear about from guys in South Beach. Hey, you ever been to South Beach? Oh, the fucking girls down there, huh?
No, that was like the trophy wife capital of the universe. Every guy down there was at least 52 and had some 23-year-old girl with her titties hanging out. It was awesome. Dressed all in white, white on white.
Outfits.
I've been to South Beach. The women are so beautiful, it's depressing, and you just want to openly cry.
Yeah.
You feel like a genetic disaster when you go to South Beach.
Felt like a busboy.
They don't even give you the time. They don't even give you a little, They don't give you nothing.
Yeah, they're all like super tall models.
They're all models.
Yeah, we were sitting in a restaurant. These three girls came in. They all almost look like somebody. Like, one almost looked like Serena.
Cindy Crawford or...
Yeah, and they're standing there, and they had, like, a fucking, like, this bodyguard standing over there. So I'm, like, going, who are they? Are they famous? And they were just rich.
It's just rich bitches.
It's like everybody in here is rich.
Except one guy with red hair.
Eating the penny.
What's the special? Don't you got a blue plate special?
I'm going to be at the Stress Factory next week, people.
Oh, that's right. You are. Next weekend?
Yeah, this weekend coming
up. Oh, this weekend. Bill Burr at Stress Factory and Patrice in Philly. So we got lots
of... Oh, Helium, right?
Helium in Philly for Patrice.
Of course.
And Stress Factory for Bill Burr.
Did you just give me shit? Like I was pouring through the newspaper and that's exactly what you're doing right now?
No, I didn't give you nothing. That was just my way of saying hi.
by looking like he was giving you shit.
Oh, is that what it is?
That's right. A hello. That's a how do you do.
Yeah, no, right. My fault.
We're just pulling shit out of our ass today, by the way, Bill, because the papers have really nothing.
Yeah, I noticed because when I came in here, you were reading your XM fucking contract. For like 20 minutes. Subsect paragraph B states,
you know, here's the problem, man.
your Lenny Bruce moment.
Fifth paragraph.
Someone asked if St. Pat's didn't happen, would you still be on satellite? I believe we would be, yes.
You think?
Yep.
Nice. Why would it happen on St. Patrick's Day?
St. Pat's Cathedral.
Oh, the St. Pat's thing.
I believe we would.
I wanted to ask that yesterday.
I believe we would have taken this road, yes.
You think so?
I think so.
You would have just left?
I think we'd have gotten fired. No, I don't know if we would have gone to satellite.
You would have left free
unless
FM?
We were fired. I don't know.
David Lee Roth, a huge disaster here in New York radio, by the
way. It's hard to tell.
They have a great article in the Daily News or the Post today about him and how he's just, they can't work with the guy.
In Radioland, it's the sour grapes of Roth. Get it? The grapes of Roth. They're always funny.
He's an old school rocker. What do people, like, that? You can't tell that dude. And he's a cool dude. You ever meet the motherfucker? He's like,
he's
a cool guy.
It just shows you what's going on in commercial radio. They just don't. Get it. Of course this guy was going to be a problem. Of course.
Looks like rock star turned shock jock David Lee Roth is having an ugly launch as Howard Stern's successor. The radio station's staffers grumbling about Roth's alleged bad behavior. My sources at 92.3 Free FM, formerly K-Rock, tell me that former Van Halen frontman and his manager, Matt Cencio, is that his name, are, quote, totally out of control and out of their league when it comes to producing a radio show. As one disgruntled employee put it, quote, this guy, Roth, is impossible to work with. A real arrogant, self-righteous ass, says a low-down spy. Quote, all the execs know they made the two biggest errors in radio history, letting Stern go to Sirius and hiring this moron Roth. He never preps for a show. He is out the door 5 minutes after the show, unless he is forced to record a commercial.
I thought we were talking about the David Lee Roth
show. Is that David Lee Roth or Anthony? he's forced to record a commercial or records ones he made errors on. According to the anti-Roth faction, he demanded that general manager Tom Chiasano do expensive renovations on Stern's old studio, then refused to use it, claiming asbestos infestation. He ripped down the walls of the temporary studio because of suspected dust behind the walls. He swears he's allergic to dust and smoke, but smells like an ashtray. The source also says Roth's manager got into a shouting match with program director Mark Chernoff on one of the first few days of the show. Then the spy says Roth insisted on decorating the halls of the studio and the studio, and then had a moving company come in and remove dozens of pictures and his fake palm trees while he mumbled about Tom and the bastards at Infinity.
Boozy, boozy, bop, city bop.
Roth said.
Oh, man.
In addition, says the source, Roth, quote, hates Tom and his vocal is vocal about it to almost everybody he talks to.
Boozy, boozy, bop. City
Bob. Roth was quoted as saying, it's almost like he wants to get fired and take the money and run.
Boozy, boozy, bop. City Bob. Oh
my God. Detailed message went to various and sundry, the station declined to comment on the whole thing.
And what did Dave have to say about that?
David Lee Roth had one last quote.
Boozy, boozy, bop. City Bob.
You know what's funny is if he was getting great ratings, he could have done all that shit and they would have been in the paper. He's a dream to work with. He is such a professional.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He just comes in. He's in a great mood. Just
hey, the reviews were
first
in.
One here, last one to leave.
Right.
Hey, we got to back up. The one reason E-Rock's here, he has the most amazing catalog of radio stuff.
I bring nothing to the table.
Oh, but Steve brought this
but
one
he
in.
Just, but he just said, but
I bring nothing to the table.
Remember, but he just said he brings nothing.
Remember that article we were reading about all the stuff we did to Howie?
Uh-huh.
And one was the high-pitch Eric bomb threat?
Yeah.
We do have the audio still.
We do?
Listen.
First skipped message.
Hey, Opie, what's up? One word of advice. You motherfucker, you suck. I hope you die. I'll put a bomb in your radio station, you motherfucker. You fucking punk ass motherfucker. Pussy fuck.
Radio edit.
Better than you, motherfucker.
No, we had to. We played that on the air, and we had to use radio edit because we weren't allowed to use Howie's name.
Yeah, even he said Howard Stern is better than you.
Even though his people were threatening to kill us with bombs and stuff, we weren't allowed
bomb
to use
bomb the
Howard's
studio.
Name.
We had to put in radio edit when
anyway,
when his name was mentioned. Terry. And then we would talk about him by saying, so did you hear fucking radio edit was doing this or that or the other thing? And then Mel actually called us in for a meeting to tell us we are not to refer to Stern as even radio edit. That became where people knew who we were talking about, so he got so angry that he went to Mel, and Mel told us not to even, we couldn't even call him radio edit. That's how crazy it got.
We got a little
sick situation that was.
Did he finish the David Lee Roth story?
He had one more quote.
He did?
Yeah.
Boozy, boozy, bop.
And the story ends just like that.
Is this out of E-Rock's iPod?
Nothing.
My radio show blows. Everybody knows.
No, that's what the song is about.
It is?
You don't even have to, like, make it
I
up.
I didn't know it was a parody. I was coming out there punching.
I was going to say, look at you, ready to go to work.
I was riffing.
You were singing over an actual parody that was
all
already
right.
Done.
I'm in a studio on the radio. Cares what the hell I'm saying. I'm taking a chance without my spandex pants and the baldness I'm displaying. Every single day I'll turn fans away. Then who's gonna listen to me when the end comes? I know I'll have done a month of shows. Then they'll bring in Sammy Hagar. Nobody cares for me. My shtick is so hokey. I am such a pony. Such a pony, such a pony. Why would somebody go and take a chance on me? I guess things are bad. Wake it up with me, babe. I'll play Van Halen songs all of the time. My show's gonna flop. I'll get dropped. I ain't got no talent. Nobody cares for me. On the radio, what a scenario, king of all media, I'm gonna flop. I ain't got no talent. Nobody cares for me. My shtick is so hokey. I am such a phony. I'm a phony, such a phony. Why would somebody go and take a chance on me? I guess things are bad. Waking up with me, babe. I'll play Van Halen songs all of the time.
Wow, that's really good.
Eddie, fire me.
Bravo.
Eddie, fire me.
It's going to go down as one of the biggest disasters in New York radio history.
Wait a minute.
How much money did
I said one
from?
Of many.
Huh? Millions.
Millions a year.
I will say millions. And there have been many New York disasters in radio.
So who should go in there? Any suggestions?
We're going to get the call soon.
Yeah.
It's very obvious.
Yeah.
Dead serious.
Yeah.
Oh, I wasn't even counting you motherfuckers. I thought you
were. No, dead serious.
We'll get the call.
We're going to get the call. Sooner than later,
in
actually.
In showbiz, which includes radio, believe it or not, anything is possible.
Where are you guys on the show business ladder?
See, they really thought after we...
Mime?
No, comedian's
the bottom.
Just above mime.
Then there's comedian. Then there's got to be DJ right
DJ
above that.
DJ somewhere in there.
We,
Yeah. We're above comedians, though. At least we can, like... We know where our job's going to be the next day.
Some comedians, some.
Yeah, some. I'm not talking Dane. Well,
see, the old company realized that they thought they could move on without us.
Yeah.
And they've tried so many different things at our old station, now with K-Rock. They're going to call us again.
Yep.
There's no doubt in our minds.
Look at the call.
Because now they're desperate. Now they're like, oh, we're ready to, you know, forgive and forget.
Well, look at it this way.
We're not leaving XM, though.
How about I rephrase it?
Mm-hmm.
Who would you endorse if they said, oh, hey, help? Who would you endorse? Who would you say, hey, man, you know what? This dude somewhere in
they're the competition.
Skogadogi.
They're the competition. We're not endorsing anyone.
There is no one. Honestly, I can't.
Even if my brother decided to do a show, I'm not endorsing him.
Opie.
Right.
You can't endorse commercial radio.
Oh, how could you say that about that?
But it's free. It's free,
Fair
FM.
Enough. Fair enough,
Opie.
Nigga.
Yeah. Good luck to you. They had 14 months to figure out who the fuck they were going to put at all of his stations, and you see who they came up with. It just goes to show you there really isn't much out there as
right.
far as pickings go.
Have you?
And that doesn't mean there's no one with talent out there. It takes talent and balls and the... You have to be fearless. You have to be able to reach a point where you can tell your program director to fuck off. You're doing the show you want to do. Same thing with the GM. And have some balls to you.
Yeah.
And
sounds
I
like
think
he's
that,
doing that, but he's not. He doesn't have the ratings.
No. And then, well
shit off the
see,
wall.
You need talent, though, to back that up, too.
Yeah.
And you got to put a little bit of time in. More than just like a month. You got to be there maybe 3-6 months.
He'll be out by spring.
And then when you get a following... This is the Boston O&A plan. When you get the following, then you do whatever you want. Whatever you want, except sex in a church, by the way. That doesn't
say the
work.
Mayor died.
You know, isn't it good
to
see
the mayor died helped us out.
Yeah, that helped.
We doubled our salaries doing that.
That was good. It is nice
that was a good
to
one. That
see.
Was a good, okay. That was a great one for us.
By the way, on a side note with the Sex for Sam thing, it is nice to see Jim Cook actually being brought back into the fold of Sam Adams. He's on all their commercials now.
Yeah. He had to go away for a few
years. They put him in a closet and shut that door and locked it. Jim Cook. Hi, I'm Jim Cook. You remember me. I was involved with the Opie and Anthony Sex for Sam promotion. put him in a closet.
Yeah.
And now they bring him back out, and he's selling his beer again.
They're like, they got rid of him and got some pilgrim to do the spots for
yeah.
a while.
Ah, yeah. Sam Adams.
I felt so bad for that guy.
Oh, you
How
know something?
They pay you got to dress up Sam Adams. You can't even tell your family you booked something on TV.
Yeah, did you see me? I'm Sam Adams. I hold the pewter mug, and I, no?
Yeah.
They, but it is because Jim Cook is a really good guy.
He's
and
a
he was
great
always
guy.
A friend of the show, and it's good to see that he's back with them.
And I will bet money that he will be back advertising
you think?
On the Opie and Anthony program.
Would be nice.
It's gonna be.
Have him back
it's gonna on. Take a little more time, but you watch. By the way, that was David from New Jersey doing the David Lee Roth parody. He's a friend of Voss's.
Is he?
Yeah.
Wow.
And he did a great job with that. David from New Jersey. Thank you.
A friend of Voss.
Would that be little the talent? Now you just go,
yeah. I'm kind of like, now I'm not as into him.
If you had said that first, I probably would have said, it can't be good as Voss's friend.
Yeah.
Let's go to Steve. Steve, what's up?
Hey, what's up, shit dicks?
Hey.
Quick question. Do you still have tape of that lunatic Anthony reciting Howard Stern's name over and over back when you were on NEW?
Oh. Well, they would start dumping out every time we mentioned his name, so then we're like, you know, this is bullshit. So we just said it over and over again until they ran out of delay.
They ran out of delay, and then they had to turn our show off and go to a Van Halen record.
Yeah, coincidentally, it was the Van Halen record.
They used to have a box with a key and a button in the general manager's office. It was an actual key, like launching an ICBM. And when they ran out of delay, which we had huge amounts of delay and various buttons all around the place that could be hit by numerous people to dump out of our show. When they ran out of the delay and we were back actually live, if we said something bad, the key was turned, the button was pushed, the station was completely detached from its ability to broadcast, and a tape would play from the Empire State Building, from the transmitter.
Was it another motherfucker with a key that he had to turn it?
Turn your key,
turn
sir.
Your key. Now.
Turn your key, sir. Gun at his head.
Wait, think about this, man. Think about it.
We have to take the human element out of the loop.
The code doesn't match. The
code. And, yeah, there was a tape at the transmitter, at the Empire State Building, that would play Jump by Van Halen. And that was the song,
talking
right?
About love. Talking about love.
It was Ain't Talking About Love?
Ain't Talking About
Love.
It
was Jump.
Yeah.
Ain't Talking About Love would start playing, and we were off the air.
We were off the air.
So we actually got to the point where they had to go to this because we just kept reciting
y'all
our
name. Y'all can suck my... Oh, hey, you!
Hey,
you
say... hey, hey! Dan,
Dan, Dan. Woo! Oh, hey, you! Who said that? Y'all can kiss my motherfucking... Might as well jump!
Hey, hey, hey!
Yeah.
That's what it was.
Oh, God.
This is what people
that
heard.
That must have just been miserable.
Oh, they were rewiring that joint on a weekly basis.
But that was just because of Stern or even before that?
It was
getting miserable.
It was when we started getting popular and they were afraid of what we were doing because we weren't so far under the radar. We used to be able to do shows that were about, I mean, we had a girl get down on completely naked, sit on the floor right behind Opie, and smoke a cigarette with her pussy. She actually was inhaling through it and blowing smoke rings through it. And to the best of our abilities, adhering to FCC regulations, we described what was going on the air. This, nowadays, doesn't matter how you describe it. Doesn't matter what type of 3 degrees of separation you use for the word pussy, you could not ever do that.
Her labia is wrapping around a marble.
Ew.
And her stomach is going in.
Ew. She ain't talking about love.
Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah. That's what you would hear.
And she, okay. All right, not labia.
Even.
Not labia.
You
okay.
Couldn't say, we got to the point where they weren't allowing us to say her most intimate of areas. She
so
would take a
that?
Cigarette. Let, now get this. She would take her most intimate of areas and take a cigarette and put it in her most...
Wait a minute. So she's taking a cigarette. Now you can say cigarette, right?
Yeah, yeah.
She's
we're
taking
back.
A cigarette.
We're back, yes.
We're taking a cigarette.
Right. Yeah. All right, let's try again.
Okay, let's try it. She's taking a cigarette and she's... Okay, you know she has a navel. And she also has a space under the navel. And then, okay. All right, let's make this. We're trying to help regular
see,
radio.
See, by
now,
space under the navel, how much imagination do you have
okay.
to have to
all
know
right.
that you mean vagina?
Now, I can say cigarette.
That's the lawyer now.
How many orifices are there in the human
come on,
body?
Underneath there? What are we talking, the hole in your kneecap, idiot? We know what you're fucking talking about.
We can say cigarette. We can say
cigarette. Cigarette can be said.
Cigarette's good.
Okay, we have a cigarette.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
Now, she has a spinal column.
All right. All right. Good.
Now, if you work down to the 14th vertebrae.
Uh-huh. 14th
okay.
vertebrae.
The pubic bone.
And you turn it around.
Sorry. We were right there.
I almost had it, Bill.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Free FM. It's free radio. You don't have to pay for this.
Okay. Okay.
Free FM getting no buzz.
Right. None.
They got a whole lineup of new... edgy quote
because this is what you'll
shows.
Get for free.
Right.
Guys,
how
trying
many,
to describe
how
shit.
How many cavities are on the human body? We're gonna
wow.
Count
are we
down.
Talking nasal sinuses?
Okay, nasal sin, not the nasal sinuses.
Eyes,
not
two,
the ear holes.
Not uh-huh. the ear holes.
Not the eye holes. Not the mouth. Not the half a hole of the navel.
Uh huh.
Not
okay.
Not the,
you might have something there. He might have something there. This
all
baby.
Right. Okay. So
not
far
a,
we're in.
Not the not until I get a ring area.
No, no.
Oh, wow, that's...
No, it's still going.
Not
still
until
going.
I get a ring area. All right, I
but
think
the
you can...
last one...
The last one left.
The last one left...
The last...
...has a cigarette dangling from it and is being inhaled. and exhaled. It is amazing.
I think he got it. Yay! On Free FM, ladies and gentlemen.
Isn't Free FM fun?
Wasn't that hilarious?
Wait a minute.
Now let's take the 50 phone calls.
Dude, I don't know what you were talking about. What were you talking about? There, I heard you talking, but I didn't understand. Dude, what hole did you mean? Dude, why don't you just say...
Oh, the caller's ruined it for us.
There's got to be a way to explain smoking a cigarette with your pussy.
Yeah, like that.
Yeah, you just say it.
It's going to cost you a little bit a month.
Eric in Connecticut. Eric.
God damn.
Hey, guys. I've been a listener since, like, 99. The first show I ever listened to, you guys did, you had a girl in there launching hard-boiled eggs out of her snatch and a blind guy trying to hit him with a wiffle ball bat.
The old days before it was called Free FM, when it truly was free. It was like a wasteland. We had a blind guy, Blind Dave, who the first time he came in, we weren't convinced he was blind, so we threw shit at his face. And we had a girl who had a very good talent. She could shoot eggs out of her snatch. So we set her up outside the studio, mic'd everything.
She's a headliner.
Yeah. And she shot eggs out as we had the blind guy swinging. We'd tell him, like, swing.
Yeah.
Until he could hit the eggs.
It sounded like this.
It's Ivory and her amazing egg-shooting twat.
Of course, today is the egg-shooting day.
Dave, the blind guy, is here. He's going to attempt to catch some of the eggs that are being shot out.
Yeah, look, she's already loaded up. She's got one in the clip.
Reloading. All right, she's loading you-know-what. She's leaning back.
Whoa!
Oh, wait a minute!
6 feet!
Hold on a minute!
Well, that's 8 feet.
Ivory has reloaded.
Oh, that one. Yeah, that one just over 8 feet. About 8 feet, 2 inches, I would say.
We got the blind guy about 6 feet away from ground zero. Okay, here we go. Dave, the blind guy.
Oh, yeah! He got it! He got it! Oh, what a day for sport. Good eyes, good eyes. Oh, sorry.
Jesus.
Yeah, there it was.
Ground zero, we called it.
Ground zero. You see how perfectly
we were able
to
call it
that?
Ground zero. She would launch it from ground zero.
Yeah.
Man. Dude, why is she downtown?
And before
Wait,
you
that
call
was 99,
up,
right?
Yeah.
So that was pre.
Oh, yeah.
We invented ground zero. Yes.
Before you call up and say, why aren't you doing that again, that fine lady, I think, died of AIDS or something. So we need to find a new one.
How about that?
She had some kind
and
of problem.
And then there was the time we had a lot of vagina involved. We had a woman take a cell phone and shove it up there, and then we called it to see if you could actually get a signal inside a girl's vagina.
She later died of ovarian cancer.
Yeah. And think, this is going back a few years. It wasn't like you could take a little pebble phone like Opie's got.
Have less pussy on since you can have more pussy on?
The thrill is not like it used to be because people could get the pussy stuff all over the place now.
It's easy to get on the internet. It's
like the coming
I
of
don't
age.
Know. If it happens,
it happens.
We have it. The wiffle ball bat is still there. We've used it. We had three girls. We had three girls in one shot. Was it three or four in one day? I think it was the first day Norton was gone.
Yeah.
Out in L.A., we had three or four girls come in here, and all of them took the wiffle ball bat day.
Let's go to...
Unfortunately, the Pal Talk cam wasn't up that day. Sorry, kids.
Let's go.
They've had to watch 3 weeks of us sitting here.
Let's go to Jay in Connecticut. Jay.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Hey.
I remember celebrating the 4th of July, shooting a bottle rocket out of her.
Oh, yeah.
That was another one where we set up a girl.
See, punch it out.
4th of July.
As a launcher. Put a bottle rocket in her vagina. We built a heat shield around it so she wouldn't be injured. And then just kind of let her loose.
Pop.
Dude, in a office.
In the studio. We launched it right down the hallway.
Just launching bottle rockets down the hallway.
That was free.
And no one told us no.
We had a wonderfully degrading show on free.
No
FM.
One told us no. They were too scared to say no.
And now,
on
you guys
that
sound
level.
Like you guys sound like old hippies when they tell you like how much weed you could have got for that
hey,
money.
Man. You know, you
the
get
whole
a,
fucking bag was full.
Dude, four finger lids, $10.
Oh jeez. Now y'all yeah. can just be like anything. Oh, today we're gonna have some a bitch shit a dump truck out of an asshole, and it's like, nah, we don't feel like doing it. You can explain it. She squeaked the headlight is coming out of her. As right yeah. now is nothing.
No, we still do the stuff. We've done cherry darts, and
yeah.
we don't have to defend
cherry
ourselves.
Cherry darts
you
were
know.
Fun.
You
well,
have
wait,
this
wait,
stuff.
The squirter with Big A
the
with
squirter.
The
yeah,
in the
come
face.
On.
That was,
oh, right. is that disgusting?
That was wonderful.
And
radio.
We're starting up what is it, American Mess on Friday.
American Mess.
You're
going to
be one of the judges on Friday?
Friday, yeah, I'll come.
Are you here? We're doing American Mess open call starting this Friday. Every Friday we're going to have open call for the next Freaks.
American Idol style rules. With complete messes.
You could come in if you think you could do the egg shooting trick. You could come in if you are missing a body part.
That was awful.
Talks.
Yeah, awful.
Talk funny, whatever. Awful. Whatever. It's going to be an open call
that
this Friday.
That was horrid.
That was some of the worst egg shooting that we've had on this program since the beginning.
I got to tell you, this guy's name is brilliant. His name is 32 Across.
Oh, very good.
32 Across, you're brilliant.
Thanks, boys. How you doing?
What do you got for the show today?
You guys should explain to Patrice about the Louis Anderson Family Feud bit, and that was the closest that you guys didn't get kicked off the air. That was brilliant.
Hmm.
Yeah.
I don't know what.
Oh,
that...
I suck. Punch it out.
No, I was.
No, that was good. We were just kind of pondering it. But
right, now people are bringing up all
yeah,
sorts of stuff.
Yeah, it's not.
You know what? You go to OAVirus.com. You could hear like Jackie the Knife Girl. Someone's mentioning the Louis Anderson bit. I'm sure is up there. Go to OAVirus.com for all the old
Father.
Material.
Nothing was worse than him on the. I think it was 60 Minutes of one of those shows, just talking about this alcoholic, abusive father that. You know, I turn tragedy into comedy. Yeah? Where's the comedy?
Where is it?
Where the hell is it, Louis?
All I hear is
when
tragedy.
He was sitting there and then it ruined. Comics cannot open up in a public forum like 60 Minutes or 2020 because it's all you think about when you see him. Now, I never found Louis Anderson that funny, you know, but when I see him now, all I think is. He would hit me with whiskey bottles, and my enabling mother allowed me to gain so much weight that the schoolyard children would beat me senseless. It was just horrid to watch. Turned me into an introverted homosexual. All right, Louis, where's the funny? Dab your head with the rag and say, I sweat, and if I didn't, I'd explode. I move the mic stand and say, let me move this out of the way so you can see me. Do one of those fat gags.
Yeah, help us out a little bit with
yeah,
some
yeah, do something. I don't want to hear about your father smacking you until you bled. Then I was sexually assaulted by an uncle at 8. That might have led to my eating disorder.
Great
he
stuff, Louie.
He bent me over a buffet table. Yeah, that, I think, I don't know why it gave me a love for the buffet table. I think as I was taking it in the ass, I was looking at the table saying, save me, save me. At least there's something good and there's something sure. good. I was eating off of the roast beef slicing table as he was doing it to me, so I could never get enough roast beef.
High carb rate. I ain't fucking gonna die.
We interrupt this program to bring you the Ozone Midget Scene of the Day.
Who saw this coming? Chaos from Whackbag. What's up?
What's happening, guys? I was at my local Walmart. I happen to be walking over by the electronics department. I see this ladder moving by itself. I look over the counter. Little bitty guy just happened to be carrying it. I started laughing my ass off.
A little midget carrying a ladder. Did he work there?
Yeah.
And he was going to, I guess, use the ladder to get something that was easily yeah, accessible to a real human.
Yep.
Yeah.
I thought it was hysterical.
I didn't catch that for half a second.
Nothing funnier than a little midget moving something because it looks like it's moving itself for a while. And you freak out and then you go, oh, it's one of those.
It's one of those.
Meanwhile, back at the show.
So.
Yeah, it's not, you know, let's look back. Look, people bringing up the Buffalo Road Show.
I know, we're trying to move on.
Most offensive song contest, which I don't know how we ever got away with, but we did. Mm-hmm. Right, we got in trouble for that one.
Someone's requesting Donna Summer tickets, actually.
Summer!
We could play that going into break.
That's old, man. That goes back to Boston.
Yeah, this is a Boston thing. We used to have these housewives.
Our phone number was very close to one of the, like, hack kind of radio stations up in Boston. So they would miss dial all the time and say, "Did I win?" Like, that would be the first thing. And we were playing music or talking. We would say nothing. So we'd be like, "What are you trying to win?" You know, and the people would tell us, and we'd just kind of fuck with them.
We'd kind of just riff a little bit.
And illegally put them on the air, you know.
And give things like that.
Against all FCC regulations.
Ah, why not?
Fuck it.
So this lady called us thinking she won Donna Summer tickets. We'll play this going into break. Bill Burr in studio playing The Stress Factory.
Yeah, 732-545-HA-HA.
All weekend long starting Thursday?
Yeah, Thursday through Saturday.
And Patrice O'Neill in studio playing Helium Comedy Club in Philly. This weekend starting Thursday as well.
Yes, sir.
All right, here's Donna Summer. And we got lots more to do after this.
Jesus. Sleeping during the break?
He was out. He's a pro, though. You see it? Second the music started playing, he woke right back up again.
Oh, yeah, today he's a pro.
Yesterday,
right in the middle of live on the air, he fell asleep.
Patrice gives me love with my lines, right? So yesterday, I had a line, and I was in the zone. I'm like, the line is a good line. You just know sometimes, right? So I'm feeling good. I do the line, and Ant's giving me nothing, which is fine. I look over to Patrice. I'm like, I know he's going to give me one of those big Patrice O'Neill laughs, right? And I look over, and here's Patrice just, she's going to take this picture? No, you're not. Because that's the one they'll use. There's what? Patrice with his head back like this, snoring away. I'm like, damn.
That's when he was doing this whole fucking...
Patrice doesn't get up till like, what, 2 in the afternoon? 3?
At least 4 if I can help it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lately,
all you
I've
comics.
Had jobs for some
it's
reason.
All of you comics, just you sleep in late. It's a wonderful life. And then
but we work till like 2. I mean,
we
do 20 minutes of comedy, then we hang out giving each other shit until 2 in the morning.
But that's fun too. Yeah. Like, I understand.
As opposed to what? Fun too, as opposed to
getting up at an ungodly hour of the morning.
What, having naked girls come in here shooting stuff
all
out
right.
of their pussies?
It could be worse.
Getting free tickets to concerts?
It could be worse.
That
I understand.
Saves the Metallica? I mean, come on.
I understand. But afternoons now.
I'm
now
used
that
to
was the lifestyle.
I'm used to sleeping till I get up. Like, until my body goes, what the fuck?
Get out of bed already.
For no reason.
That's
do nothing,
what I
but
like.
It's just like, can't get up.
I don't like being told when I have to get up. I don't know, like an alarm going off and then having to get up. I want to get up when my body says,
you want to take out when
get out of bed. Yeah.
Every day, I get up at 5 o'clock to get here, like, because it takes me about a half hour to just take a shower. But every day I get up, I sit on the side of bed, I go, I should just... call and say something to Ben.
Yeah.
Just say, I can't make it.
We're going to be late.
Can you call somebody else? I can't
help
make it
me,
here.
Please.
I can't
I
get here.
I stagger into the bathroom every morning. As the light comes on, you hear your pupils slam shut, and you look in the mirror just, oh, I can't.
Yeah.
I'm exhausted.
I always wake up like mad because I always forget that I'm doing radio. And I think for some reason I put the alarm on for no reason. I woke up this morning doing that. I go, oh, what the fuck?
Arnold!
Like, no! Come on! Yeah.
What is this for? The furtherment of my career? And there's some truck driver driving going, these cocks, like, he gets up at 3 and he has to drive to
Alabama.
Saying things aren't worse.
And a truck driver has to know where to go. Because I drive sometimes and there's so many places where it says, get the truck driver stay the fuck over. You, like, they can't drive in the fast lane.
Yeah.
They can't drive on parkways.
Parkway.
They can't drive fast.
They just can't do shit. And I'm complaining like, oh, I got to get up and try to be famous. Fuck.
Yeah, but you know what? Everybody who gets into entertainment, you get into it because you don't want a real fucking job.
Yeah.
That's why you do it.
All right,
you don't want a boss.
Yeah.
Well, let's move on.
I don't want to get up early either.
Let's go to Chris on Long Island. Chris.
Good morning, ladies.
What's up, Chris?
Hello, Bill Burr, my little only MySpace friend. It's Chris from LiveWire.
Oh, hey, what's up, man?
Hey, Patrice, I was watching Flavor of Love the other day, and I don't know if you noticed this, Opie, when you watched it. When they went to the commercial for the preview for next week.
Yeah.
And they showed the lineup of the chicks that were on the next week, so you already knew who was eliminated.
Oh, they
kind of blew it.
Blew it.
Yeah. The payoff is watching the whole fucking thing for an hour to see who they gets eliminated.
So they show the promo, and then they show who's left, so you know who's not going to get knocked out because you see them for the next week's promo.
Exactly.
Yeah, that is kind of a blow-it move.
Yeah, VH1 doesn't exactly have a Scorsese over there.
No.
All right. He kind of goes, hey, Patrice.
Yeah. Hey, Patrice, remember Opie? Hey, Bill.
Hey, Patrice, I want you to talk to those guys over at VH1 and tell them to stop fucking up. Sure, fucking people I don't know. I'm just an asshole in front of a green screen. With white people walking around, I don't know who the boss is.
Yes, boss.
Yes, boss.
You the boss?
Somebody said Flavor of Love, not to be offensive.
Let's go to North Carolina. Bill, what's up?
Yeah, Bill. I want to talk to Patrice about him cracking on Appalachian State. And it's not Appalachian, it's Appalachian.
It don't matter.
It just doesn't
it
matter.
It really doesn't
That's
matter.
That's exactly it. That's how
the point.
Obscure it is. No one knows how to say it.
Appalachian State is hot.
Does anyone care?
What an awful school.
That was part of WebJunk 20, Patrice O'Neill's new show on VH1.
They have one.
Thanks for the setup, Bill, because we're going to play some of our favorite clips from there. We got three quick ones. We got the Bush clip. We got the John Dacre clip doing awful versions of really good songs. Really good old songs, I guess. And then the Dr. Phil clip, which is just classic.
Yeah, make sure you get a shot of Opie there as E-Rock is eating his cereal and mayonnaise. Get that. I hope you got a tight shot there.
We got the Daily News in doing their little photo shoot.
Yes. I think you ought to do something
not
with a cool
distracting.
Little depth of field where out of focus eating motherfucker is right there, but Opie's in focus. Out of focus cereal bowl and gorging idiot in the foreground.
Too bad you weren't here earlier when he was sucking mayonnaise packages.
Look at Eric.
He just turned his hands up like,
what did I do?
Yeah, like he'll be eating a sandwich, and rather than put like the mayonnaise on the sandwich, he tears it open and just squeezes
you
it in.
You suck the 47-hand mayonnaise package?
He sucks the last bit of mayo out of the package.
Out of the package.
You know how many mayonnaise packages I touched till I found the right one?
All right. Sucking on it like space food.
So from WebJunk 20, Patrice O'Neill, VH1, here's the Bush clip we were talking about earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Where, it's explained within the clip here.
Did you hear these rumors that President Bush is drinking again? Have you heard this? I mean, it's frightening. I'm not sure it's true. It's probably not, but I'm telling you. take a look at this. Take a look.
I'd have stood up here a year ago. In one of my many press conferences and told you that in the next year I make this prediction to you that over 10 million Iraqis, including many Sunnis, will vote for a permanent government. I think you probably will say... There he goes again.
That is brilliant. That's Craig Ferguson on his show. Great observation.
It's really cool with the video because the video kind of makes it work also, but the audio is great.
Yeah.
It's just
that's actual audio?
It's slowed down.
They slowed it down slightly to make him sound drunk.
Slowed it down, and it absolutely sounds like he's hammered.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Why didn't we think of that?
Ugh. Damn it.
I hate the obvious ones. And then there's the John Dacre clip that also was featured on WebJunk 20. This guy's just a complete tool.
Oh.
He's scary to look at as well when he's trying to sing these songs.
My name is John Dacre. Lord is risen today. Hallelujah. Sons of men and angels say hallelujah. Your voice in triumph song.
Once there was a girl who
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's some more rain.
Maury. That's Maury.
Maury. Will ring, ting-a-ling-ling, ting-a-ling, and the bell ring. Maury.
Maury. Sing about the eel.
Just on the piano getting mad.
Now he's doing an Eddie Vedder.
And you should see the lady on the piano. She's not even paying. She's just grooving some, you know, large marge type of lady from, like, Hicksville. And she just, if you notice, she's off beat, but she just in her own space. Like, and he just sucks, and she's just like,
what is she supposed to do? Like, keep up with this guy?
She's just whining. She's doing a right hand with one arm. And
that is a clusterfuck.
Awful.
What is that from?
Amore.
Well, it was featured on Web Junk 20. That's the longer version of the clip.
Yeah, that's this guy the real version.
Yeah, where do you find him? Like, what is he? Is that a podcast or is it on a religious channel? Where does this guy come from?
It's off iFilm, but the dude is, it's a lady. They get, it's public access, like it's somewhere
public access.
In just wherever.
Yeah,
that
the
they make crazy. And everybody in the situation, John Dacre is not a weirdo in this situation. You know what I'm saying? There's another girl that's just awful. She's singing like, you know, love is... It's just a lot of retards doing whatever they do.
Fantastic.
And it's just like some public access thing. And it's run by the lady doing the piano.
Yeah.
Like, she just put everybody together because some preacher couldn't show up, but John Dacre was available. She's like, we have John Dacre. And she gives it an intro, like a bad college intro. Like, the worst intro ever when you go to colleges for a comic is when they have a fucking idiot who introduces you by name first, then reads your thing. It's like, well, who we have? Billy Burr is here. Billy Burr does Opie and Anthony, and he has an HBO special.
Thing. Yeah.
And here he is.
Coming to the stage. And here he is. Oh.
Billy
smattering
Burr
of applause
again.
It's supposed to be, ladies and gentlemen, Billy Burr!
Yeah, no, they don't say, they just say your name in the beginning.
Oh,
and then they just
the
read credit.
It's gotta go at the end.
And then he's been on Premium Blend, and he did Comics Come Home with Dennis Leary. And then they just walk away from the mic, and then people are like, do we clap here?
When do we?
I always say that to them. I go, I don't give a shit what credits you say, just say my name last.
Last. They don't get it. Patrice O'Neill is coming out now. He's will be performing here, and he's been on HBO.
That's just horrible. They
just walk off.
That is not.
Oh, it's even bad enough that they don't walk up to the mic and at least get the crowd like, hey, thanks for coming out tonight. Give yourself a round of applause. That hacky shit to bring. They just go up there and start talking half the time.
Get some kind of energy going.
Half the time people are still talking.
I don't care how little money I get paid for colleges. Someone goes with me that takes the brunt of the pain because it's never good. Never.
It's brutal.
All right, we got one last clip.
You always make sure you have a buffer.
I bring somebody to
take
the heat.
He's a smart guy.
He's always
a smart comedian.
Insulation.
Yeah. Hey, we got one more clip from Web.
Go ahead.
One more clip from Web Junk 20.
Beach.
This is the Dr. Phil clip that I found very, very disturbing and funny at the same time.
Where is he messed up on this?
They're talking about oral sex.
Oh.
Older couple. They have to be, looks like they were in their 50s, right? Early 50s, maybe?
Real Ohio looking. You
Ohio
know,
looking.
Real,
just
you
two
know,
messes.
Right. She knits and he goes to the pharmacy.
Yeah.
Just, he's a pharmacist.
Oh, geez,
she's a professional sweater maker. Then, you know, doesn't
talk about oral sex. And then this is
needlepoint champion.
Oh, my.
And,
oh, my goodness.
And go. Sweater.
This is my favorite thimble. I got this as a graduation gift in 1953.
Here's a potato chip shaped like Lincoln's face.
So it's an older couple. They're having oral sex, and she describes his definition of oral sex.
Uh-huh.
Very disturbing here.
Where is he messed up on this?
With his very, very specific definition that he figures that he needs to ejaculate directly into my mouth for it to constitute oral sex.
He's a good man.
You got it?
And you gotta understand, he sat there. He sat there when she said that.
Yeah.
He didn't even change. Like, he didn't even go, oh, my God, you said that. He sat there like, and what, bitch?
Uh-huh.
What's your point? I need to squirt one in them fucking cheeks. So,
it doesn't constitute oral.
Wow. Another?
Sighting of
wow.
The day.
Who really saw this coming? Two in one day? Man purse?
We did this out.
New Mexico?
Yeah, I had a midget sighting for you guys.
Yeah?
Do tell.
Yeah, there. I was just at the gym, and I saw a little Ewok-looking midget needing a step stool to get onto the treadmill.
No way.
Yes.
He's lying.
Oh, he's stop it.
Lying.
I know. Did he have his little hands above his head as he held onto the, on the treadmill?
Adjusting the fucking.
There's no reach in the controls. There's no.
What's the thing you call when it makes it go up?
Oh, the incline.
The incline.
Practicing some gymnastic moves in between miles.
Jane, stop this crazy thing. Jane!
We actually need one of the workers to come over and help her with her little stool.
It's a girl?
Yeah.
That's great. Trying to get those big fat thighs.
Yeah, one thing midgets don't really got to do is work those thigh muscles.
Oh, yeah. Down to like a workable size.
Yeah.
They're all built like Robert Newhouse.
Jesus. You know, midget is the racial slur for those people?
Yeah, that might be called little people.
Yeah, they call it the M word.
The M word.
They do. The M word. Midget.
The M word.
Yeah. Migger.
Midger.
I've never called him a migger in my life.
You dirty little midger.
All right, taking all the fucking jobs.
Taking all the jobs.
You come to this country.
You don't think I could be a... You don't think I can be a fucking pipe cleaner? You don't think I can get inside of a pipe and scrub it?
You think I don't want to work at the circus?
You think I can't be a fucking Cabbage Patch model? You don't think I can squat down? You can make a Cabbage Patch Kid model out of me?
It's all affirmative action. They're giving him all the jobs.
I would have killed the Ben and Austin Powers. All I'm doing is these student films. This is bullshit. You damn miggers.
You fucking miggers. You don't think... Dirty niggers, you don't think I can measure xylophones? You don't think my height? You don't think I can hide in an accordion, you motherfucker?
It is two for Tuesday, so let's do two midget sightings in a row. It's lard cake hands.
Mm-hmm. Hey, guys, I got the midget sightings and midget sightings for today.
All right.
I'm a paramedic, and yesterday I pronounced the midget dead.
Oh,
no way. I'm not believing this.
Yeah, they do die.
What, do you get hit with a frisbee?
Unfortunately, it's nothing funnier than just found him laying on his bed naked with his little legs hanging off the bed.
Oh.
Oh, man.
That is tragic.
You just put him, in your lunchbox and carry him down to the morgue?
Well, we threw him in a Ziploc body bag. Okay.
Did you just do a CS on him? Because he wasn't big enough for an eye. Oh. He just did a C.
What did the little fella die of?
I have no idea. He was just laying on the bed.
Oh. He was feeling low.
He did call the hospital with shortness of breath.
All right, guys. Bunching out.
He had a little of this and a little of that. That's so
I'm trying to think
up.
Of something low to the ground that he bumped his head on.
Oh, shit.
Meanwhile, back at the show.
Anyway, so that oral sex thing.
That's some clip.
That's incredible. WebJunk 20 with Patrice O'Neill and VH1. Check it out. Take a peek at that.
You've been checking out any podcasts?
A little bit.
Go to Apple.com. There's a few podcasts out there. I downloaded one. There's two guys that do kind of a tech show thing. They have they're on a couch with laptops, but they drink beer the entire time.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess it's about 40 minutes long, and they progressively get more and more drunk during the show. And one guy, you can tell, can kind of hold his beer. The other guy completely can't. And the one guy that can
really is into the tech end of things. So he's, as the show goes on, he's trying to show him like this new technology. He goes, here's a camcorder that I got for Christmas, and my father wound up getting the same one. And he's like, do you think anyone cares about your camcorder? Like, and they both get hammered
by
the end of the show.
Of
I thought that was pretty cool.
We gotta
get I'll dig up some. I've been trolling through a few of them.
Really
there's a lot of just boring crap. But
we really want to start featuring some of the better
video
podcasts.
Or what's going on.
Right, we'll
and it's video, so you see the guys.
Yeah, right on.
Right. On there. A lot of fun.
All right. There's not much in the news today. That's why we're kind of screwing
there
off.
There were a couple of interesting stories. The Paul McCartney story really hit me.
Listen to this.
His wife, what's her name there? Heather Mills?
Yeah, I'll read this real fast. It's short. Wife to Sir Paul.
It's short. So is the corpse.
Pot or me?
Yeah.
Listen to this.
Pot or me?
Heather Mills said she gave Sir Paul McCartney a strict ultimatum as their relationship blossomed. Quit smoking marijuana, or forget walking down the aisle.
Huh?
I told him I would not get married to him if he was taking drugs. I hate it, Heather 37 told London's Observer newspaper. I could not have him lying to our child about not taking drugs and then going out for a sneaky puff. He says he had a good incentive.
A good incentive.
To stop smoking pot.
Her ultimatum?
Yeah. You don't give a Beatle an ultimatum.
Excuse me, yeah.
You think John Lennon would have taken that?
No.
He would have thrown her off the balcony.
Yeah, with the one leg.
This is a chick with one leg giving up rules?
Yeah.
It's Paul McCartney.
You know what? He obviously didn't sign a prenup because there's no way to take that. She wouldn't even brought it up.
This was before they got married. She wanted him to stop smoking pot.
There is no way Paul McCartney should be taking an ultimatum from anybody.
Especially a bitch with one foot.
The second wife. Not even the one he wanted. The one he wanted and married died. She's like the stand-in.
He really has just been pussy-whipped for like four fucking decades.
Yeah.
Yeah. Someone needs to help that guy.
He sat there and let Linda sing on those songs where she is just... making an abortion of a classic Beatles song.
He's like, love was just an open book, and I said, live and let live. You know you did, you know you did, you know you did. Oh, you
she's playing
fucking
keyboards.
Bitch.
Did you ever hear the Hey Jude?
With her in it?
Yeah, this is the real. Oh, my God.
You never heard this? With her in it?
Oh. Dude, she had such a bad singing voice that the engineers finally decided to just isolate her mic. And hit record. This
you know,
is real audio from a Paul McCartney concert where she was singing background vocals. I guess they turned her down in the mix, but this guy said, this is way too good. I got to share this with others. So he taped just her microphone as Hey Jude is being sung.
I'm guessing she was probably kind of cunty to the guy and started actually thinking that she was actually a musician.
Probably
and he was just like, all right,
part of
bitch.
The band.
All right, bitch.
Yeah.
Yeah, oh, I'm sure she probably, you know. They knew she stunk.
Can I get more bass in my monitor, please?
Yeah. I don't think you're turning me up. I can't
every
hear me
fucking
in the mix.
Show. I just can't hear what the fuck I'm playing
like
up here.
She's the one every time looking at the sound guy, pointing at her ear and putting her thumb up like, more monitor. I can't hear me. Louder in the mix. You want loud in the fucking mix,
she holds the earphones, one earphone over the ear to get the tone and holds the
finger on the other. Na, 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 Hey Jude.
This is the real deal. Let's all
into it.
Ugh, this is actually Linda McCartney.
You'll think this is a joke. This is so bad.
This is the real deal. Listen to this.
Just isolated her mic.
She's just falling off a cliff.
I'm hitting a ledge every time.
Oh my God, dude.
Gets really bad right here. Listen.
What the fuck? A classic song. This song is almost sacred.
Is it any wonder
they broke up?
No one could fuck that up.
No, no.
They should have put in a shower like Bonnie Rubble. No, no, no,
no. The only place you could see
it. Soap, 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 soap.
Gotta be in the
soap.
I gotta be in the shower, Fred.
Put that bitch in the shower.
You remember that shit? We got a square from way back there.
Skeet, bop, boom, yeah, lip, bop, bop.
Oh, when the Saints come marching in. Hey, oh, when the Saints come. We got Bonnie Rubble looking for trouble.
Looking for trouble. Listen to a rock, listen to a roll, listen to the itty bitty mockingbird.
And the golden smog.
Skiddly.
Scootily. Wow, wow. Yeah. Can you hear him? Well, grab him.
Listen to the mockingbird.
Pow, pow.
Listen to the mockingbird.
Hip flip. Mockingbird is wailing his last song.
Sounded nothing like Fred.
We also have Yoko.
Oh, his legs would be doing like the Claude Van Damme slip. I go, 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 go.
She's stuck. Holy shit.
Dude.
Put that bitch in the tub.
Yoko Ono.
Drown her.
Yoko Ono. Down. Yoko Ono wasn't much better. You ever see Rock and Roll Circus, the documentary?
It's known that she can't sing, though. I've never heard any real special shit, but she's horrendous.
Jay Moore turned us on to this, man. You had, like, an all-star band on stage. You had John Lennon. Help me out, Ann. Who was on? Mick Jagger?
The Who? Ringo. Ringo's the king of the all-star bands.
No, but this was...
like, nine drummers.
Someone's got to help us out here. No, this was the finale.
Finale.
So it was John Lennon
Eric
on stage
Clapton.
With Mick Jagger, Eric Clapton on guitar, Jimi Hendrix guitarist.
Jeff Beck had to be there.
No, that's it. Right there.
what about the Who?
No, that was part of the whole
thing. That was part of the show, but
this is when Jimi Hendrix
went.
Was alive.
Yeah. This is where they pretty much like just did a bunch of drugs,
man.
Got together and just jammed. But the final song is what I'm getting at.
Yep.
It was Lennon on stage with Mick Jagger, Eric Clapton on guitar, and Hendrix guitarist. and they just...
How can you fuck that
How
up?
How can you fuck that
legends.
Up?
Legends.
So listen to Yoko Ono wreck this thing. It was the final song of this Rock and Roll Circus documentary. Ugh. Who has it? Derek has it? Did you fast forward a little bit or? Okay. Listen to this. So they're just jamming away, right?
There's Yoko.
Listen to Yoko.
That sounds like Poltergeist. That is a Poltergeist.
Sounds like there's an amp on her foot.
A human can't make that sound.
And is that Jimi Hendrix still playing? Like, he wouldn't stop and go, look, it's,
You think Lennon would,
It was like Hendrix's bassist or something was part of this.
But one of them, Clapton. Lennon. Clapton should have just turned around and gone, John, you fucking wife. Get her off the fucking microphone.
Give her something to whine about. Hit her over the head with the guitar or something.
Yeah, it's awful.
I know I'm not a real part of this whole thing, but dude, you know.
She is awful.
She's awful, man.
No, that's
You're
how good
not
the drugs
part
were.
Of
yeah.
this program.
What is this goof shit, man? I don't know what the...
Little known fact, it took Eric Clapton 9 years to tell his friend John Lennon that he was in a disaster.
Oh.
Marriage.
exactly.
This sounds like...
I don't know how to bring it up, mate. I just don't know how to bring it up.
Yeah, what? Yeah. Mate, thank God you...
We're doing a little callback, Bill.
Yeah.
A little callback.
My dumb divorce.
My dumb divorce. Why couldn't anybody tell me before I got divorced that she stunk?
Hey, Anthony.
Anthony, your fucking wife an abysmal human being.
Because this is what his wife sounded like when they used to get together songs at the local pub. You know what I mean?
What the hell is that? She sounds like... This sounds like a napalm strike on the Ho Chi Minh Trail. That's what it sounds like. Just screaming Vietnamese children.
I cock it now!
Wow! Let's go to Dave in Texas. Dave.
Hey.
Rats! Rats! Michael!
Linda McCartney, what a peach. I was on tour with her, and she was walking out the parking lot one day, and she saw this truck driver had a McDonald's bag on the floor of his truck, fired his ass on the spot.
For eating McDonald's?
Well,
total vegan tour, dude. I mean, there's no meat whatsoever.
Militant
you know,
vegan.
She walked out there and fucking saw that his door was open. You know, we're all standing there. She's like, whose truck is this?
Yeah.
That's his. Hey, you're fucking gone. We're like, oh, no, shit.
Unbelievable.
What up, Peach?
I told
you. Hey, I love you guys. We listen to y'all every morning out here on tour. I'm punching out.
Who are you driving for these days?
You know, I was just out with Zach Wilde, and I must have fucked up somewhere on the karmic wheel because I'm going out on a country tour next week.
Ugh.
A what?
A country tour.
Ooh.
This guy drives for the bands. All right, Dave.
The other day, you guys were fucking killing me. That was awesome. Fuck, I was laughing so goddamn hard. It was, I had to almost pull over.
What thing?
When you guys were doing the fucking top country song.
Oh, man. Yeah, should we play She Let Herself Go today?
Are we trying to make it a hit?
Is that what we're doing?
Thank you, Dave.
Are you taking payola, Opie, for this song? Because I haven't seen Dime One.
You got an 8-ball.
You got an 8-ball?
Yeah.
The record rep came in, gave him an 8-ball, and Opie's spinning this like crazy.
You know what's funny about that shit? No one said anything, but that 9 years, that exists on all levels. I remember I got a new headshot like 2 years ago, and I go to give it to my management, and I'd been with them for like 3 years at that point. I give them the headshot. Like, oh, yeah, it's great. It's great. Yeah, your last one was awful.
I'm
just like, why didn't you bring that up?
No one brings
shit
up.
And then they just start trashing my last.
Patrice brings stuff up. That's who I've noticed. Patrice will bring something up.
Patrice actually brings shit up that doesn't even need to be brought up.
Right.
Because, you know what? Because it can't be fixed.
It's just mean and
like,
insulting.
Like the size of my head. He has told me about the size of my head, for, like I can do something about it.
How do you
fix
that? Billy's like, head looks like Easter Island.
Why didn't you tell me? I'd have deflated it.
And what kills me is his head looks like a fucking butcher block, and I'm actually sitting there listening to him going like, is it too big? Do I need to work up? He justifies the size of his head because of the size of his body.
His body, right.
Oh, all right, well, I'll go eat some more cheesecake.
All right, we got to play She Let Herself Go.
And niggas hate me for that, and you talk about 9 years ago, nobody talk. And you would hate me if I go, look, oh, man, your wife is a drunk. You don't deserve this, dude. You need better. And you'd be like, dude, you out of your place. And
that's
be
why no one says anything.
You can't tell your
You
friend
can't
anything.
Tell somebody, especially
can,
right before they're getting married or something. You go, dude, you are making a big mistake.
Because then what ends up happening is the person ends up mentioning it to the girl,
well,
and then you're phased out.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry, Ope. I know you get into this thing, but I just want to say that is a sign of your own non-fucking understanding of your own life. Like, if somebody said, your girl's a hoe, I'll go, and what's your point? I know that, motherfucker. I'm not delusional. Bitch, it's a hoe. It's like your wife's a drunk and you don't deserve, you know, she don't deserve you. And you're like, you know, fuck you, get out of my life. But you got to accept what it is.
Yeah. Should have went, yeah. No one said anything. No one said anything.
No one
does. I just kind of sat around. No one does.
Let's go to She Let Herself Go.
I think when you walk in and everyone just kind of stares off into the distance.
Yeah.
That's usually like the thing. Like no one wants to say anything. People are just staring straight ahead. Like hey. Anthony and fucking cunt. I can't stand.
When you hear like. When booze is being hidden like in the Animal House when Dean Wormer walked in. And you hear clink, clink, clink when she walks in.
Yeah.
You know, she walks in a house or room or a party and people start hiding the Jack and the beers. Clink, 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 clink. What do we got? Club soda. You want some club soda?
Got some high C.
What kind of fucking party is this club
Let's
soda?
Get the fuck out of here.
Let's play She Let Herself Go.
All right.
By 80 Inch. It's one of these bits that has taken over. And now I think they're going to just start making country songs. Because what was the one we suggested today?
Oh, damn it. The oil on the hands.
Yeah. Oh, washing up before you go. Sneaky shit.
Something about the shower.
Clean up before
straight
you go.
Straight to the shower.
Straight to the shower
is going to be the next country song we get. But
coming home and going straight to the shower.
Just to let Bill know,
last week we were
listening to the top 10 country songs in America, and they have silly titles. So we would see the title, then we'd try to figure out what the song was
My
about.
My hands might have smelled like a stranger's vagina.
So there was a song on the country charts called
Somebody
She Let Herself Go. Focus, focus.
Hope he's been trying to get to this song for 15 minutes.
Focus.
And
Ellen just started dancing on TV.
We get it. She's dancing. We don't need to go there. Who gives a fuck at this point? Her stupid dancing. So one of the country songs was She Let Herself Go. So then we try to figure out what the song was about. And it turns out it's a song about a woman empowering herself and doing something about her life and letting a bad situation go. And she's going to make something better of herself.
But we thought it was just the obvious, you know. She was a hot piece of ass. She was hooked up, and in country fashion, she got fat, and he left. Right. She let herself go.
Yeah. Oh. So then a guy, one of our listeners, 80 Inch, I think his name is, he came up with this song called She Let Herself Go. The real version.
Would you shut the fuck up? There ain't no reason for you to go to the store. Stay your fat ass on the fucking couch. That's what you do all day long anyway. And if I put you on my damn truck, then that motherfucker's gonna take twice the amount of gas just to go 2 miles down the goddamn road. Said I can't take it anymore. You better lay off the path. All you do is stuff your face from morning to night. A traveling salesman out on the road, only to come back home to a heavier load. I gotta get this fat bitch out of my life, 'cause she let herself go. Let herself go. No diet plan in sight. She eats every goddamn thing inside. Let herself go. She leaves the toilet all shitty. No matter what she does, this bitch could never be pretty. It's all I can do to keep her clothed. She let herself go.
Sounds like a real song, right?
It really does. It's got the country feel. He's got a country voice.
It's got that same country sound that makes me want to kill myself.
Right.
Every time I listen to it.
It's perfect.
What is that guitar where you sit down
it's
and you
steel
play that?
Guitar. Oh,
that's
yeah.
the sound
guitar.
I was trying to
that's
do.
That's the country sound right there. Once you put a steel guitar... You can put a steel guitar in a Metallica song, and all of a sudden it's a country-ass country song.
Let's go to Ken in Jersey. He got one of those warnings from one of his friends. Ken, Jersey, what's up?
Hey, Anthony, you're totally wrong. Most of the time you think it's a joke when you're about to get married, but your friends do give you a warning. They say, are you sure you want to do this? Are you sure you want
yeah,
to
Yeah, but it's like, you sure? yeah, no.
They laugh, but they're not kidding.
And let me tell you something. At the altar, it's too late. It's too late.
It isn't.
It's never too late.
It is. You're going to be the guy? You're going to make that scene?
It's a ballsy move.
It's a ballsy move.
That is a ballsy move.
But to make a scene like that, wow.
I just remember...
That's a rough one.
I took this class in college, and a lawyer was teaching it, and he was bringing up just the nightmares of going through divorce, and he goes, I don't care if you're standing at the altar. Never forget, he said that. He goes, leave. He goes, you are going to cause your life so much less pain. Just walk right then. Just take the embarrassment. It's going to be so much better than waiting, you know, 5-6 years down the road, having kids and all that shit to
absolutely
fucking
right.
walk out.
All right. Let's go to Randy in New York. Randy.
Yo, right what's up, guys?
Hey.
Yeah, going a little back before. Do you think Paul McCartney was using her leg as a bong at all?
Oh, smoking out of the pot.
That's how this started.
Maybe that's where the ultimatum was, to stop smoking out of my leg.
Heather Mills is telling a Beatle, pot or me.
How about me smoking pot or you gimp your ass out of here and try to find another Beatle?
Lottery.
Who's been knighted? Lottery. Yeah.
Thank God.
There's one left.
Thank God, Paul
McCartney.
And
it's Ringo, you idiot.
If it wasn't for drugs, we wouldn't have had the second half of the Beatle
That's
career.
That's what I was going to say. Yeah.
Sergeant Pepper's, all that.
Right.
It was drugs.
Yeah, it was drugs that did that.
Thank God
an
earlier girlfriend didn't give the same ultimatum. We wouldn't have all that shit that came out.
I want to hold your hand.
Serious. You think the Beatles would have, you think they would have been like wouldn't have gone down in history as much?
I want to hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand.
They would have sounded like the Hanson brothers if they didn't start smoking.
Do you think
pot?
You couldn't be
really?
Wasted and
you
put,
don't hear that.
Put those satin majorette fucking outfits on?
Dude, they sang a song called The Yellow Submarine.
That's
somebody on drugs.
I think that's pre-drugs, though, isn't it? No.
No.
They
you can tell. There is a definite line when they discover drugs, and it is so apparent.
And now someone is telling Paul McCartney to lay off the pot.
Yeah.
He might still have some of this in him still.
One little puff, and
little
all of a sudden a brain cell gets hit, and it's a brilliant song
like,
coming out.
Remember me?
Yeah. Smoke your pot
Smoke
there,
your
Paul.
Pot.
Jeez. She's bitching at him. Find another Beatle. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
That's amazing. I wonder, is he too pussy to go? Let's be honest here.
You see this house you're living in? Yeah. That was because I was smoking pot with my pals.
Smoking pot and doing a lot more.
I would just
Believe me, I cut down.
I would just be able to. I'll be in the house and go.
Drop an acid.
Let me show you something. Echo, echo, echo. You see that shit? That's the living room. I will do whatever the fuck I want to do.
I'll just point at a leg. I'll be like, listen, Ahab. I'm letting Captain Ahab. I'm fucking Captain Ahab and giving you a lot of money, bitch. Look, I'll just constantly point at her foot. No one's hot enough to be missing a limb when I bet you Paul McCartney could get a 21-year-old
dude.
Easy.
Bet you. You don't just have to hot. Bet. This is not
we could
even
buy South Beach.
Yeah, this isn't even an issue that you have to say. I bet you.
Right.
This is he can.
Yeah.
He's Paul McCartney. The Beatles. There's only two left.
You just sit there, right, when she's talking shit to you, you just shake your head back and forth like, and you just keep looking at her until she shuts up, and you just keep doing this. You shake your head, look at her eye, then look at her foot.
See? Once again, Patrice, well, just something she can't help.
Can't
the whole time
about.
She brought this shit up, he'd just be going, pointing at a leg. Which one is it again?
Back to the eyes.
Hold on a second. And then knowing it and then knocking on the fake one. hello, I'm a Beatle.
Bitch, who fills your closet with left shoes?
Paul McCartney.
Paul McCartney, baby. And that's what matter of fact, that's your last name, bitch. Your nickname is Heather McCartney. How about that? And you know what? I'm going to give you a new one of those new wooden legs in the shape of a joint with no foot in it. Just, and at the bottom, I'm gonna paint it ashy like it was fucking, like it's on fire.
I was going to say,
Paul lipstick on one end from somebody sucking on it.
I was going to say, Paul fucking Cartney's joint on the side of it.
let's go to Frankie.
Made out of a whale's tooth, you fucking bitch.
Frankie.
Scrimshaw.
What's up, Frankie?
I can tell you exactly when the Beatles discovered drugs.
Okay.
Side 2, Rubber Soul.
See, that's where Paul made the mistake. An album called Rubber Soul. Heather Mills is not happy about an album called Rubber Soul.
I'm going to turn off my mind, relax, and float downstream. Later.
I want to hold your hand.
You think I would have just... I never thought of that in my life. That's
she loved you, yeah.
Paul from Jersey.
But wasn't that part of their greatness?
Hit you,
what,
yeah.
What, part of the drugs?
Oh, yeah. I mean,
in hindsight, looking where they went,
they came out.
You could look at that as like...
They came out, they were like NSYNC.
But they were
the boy band of Liverpool.
But they were bigger than One Hit Wonders when that fucking came out, though. They were super fucking
new.
Famous.
But
that
kind of new.
That shit was going to dry out.
They were done.
Yeah, that stuff was going to dry out.
They were done if they didn't...
You know, listen to Peter Noon. Listen to Peter Noon's stuff, who didn't progress on to
who's
the
that?
Drug.
Henry VIII.
Yeah, I am Henry VIII. I am.
Was he just dumb? He might have been on drugs. He's like, second verse,
same
as
the first.
I'm Henry VIII. I am. It's just like, that was a fucking hit.
Yeah, that's like saying Dexy's Midnight Runner should have smoked drugs. Maybe they would have fucking...
Me, I'm into something good.
Who's that guy?
I'm into something.
Peyton Noon. You don't
there
see him
were
walking around in
VH1? Those guys. A thousand of those guys, bands, guys. But they never went on to smoke the pot and take the LSD and sit down with the Maharishi and fucking, you know, get hammered.
I never even thought of that shit, man.
Of course. Yeah. Let's go to Paul in Jersey. He's got something.
Oh, my
on his. Paul.
Paul.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey.
Paul McCartney should give up pot when his wife can have a full-term pregnancy.
Whoa.
Oh.
Yow.
I don't know how you can beat the foot.
Ow. Wow.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, but look at Aerosmith. Aerosmith in the 70s, completely wasted. That's their best fucking music.
Some of their best shit.
Yeah,
something
of course.
Then they get cleaned up and you get Love in an Elevator.
Well, you got...
You got their most commercial success, though. Yeah. After they got off the drug.
Let's go to...
Which is weird.
Come on, man. Stick with the pro-drug fucking slant of the show.
That... is for the instant feedback bit ruining you did.
What did I do?
See? I just ruined your bit.
That's right.
The band.
Oh, you got me back.
Jesus, you motherfucker. Y'all are just
oh, we don't forget.
Evil
oh, we don't forget.
Antonio Andolini.
Yeah,
you broke my heart.
We don't forget.
I'm back to Sicily years later to split you open.
Hey, Drew, let's go.
You killed my father.
Drew.
Yes.
Go.
Hey, man.
What's up? I got the McCarthy ultimatum about 2 weeks ago.
What, pot or me?
Yeah.
But you're not a Beatle.
Yeah.
I know.
So you're not smoking pot anymore, are you?
Fuck that.
I actually got to go buy another bag today.
There you go.
All right. To the...
And yeah, blow
a beetle.
And blow weed rings in her face.
Sounds like he's on pot right now.
We're talking a beetle. He should be able to take her leg off and beat her over the head with
That's
it.
Right.
And she should still come back with a loving smile.
Or turn it into an instrument, like
yeah.
the thing that you, the fucking trombone that you have to cup over.
Yeah, the plunger. Yeah.
Watch this, bitch. I'm a carve holes in it. I'm going to turn this to a big flute. Your leg is a giant flute.
Playing her leg.
Yeah, and I want you to play your leg as I'm smoking to enhance my high.
And sing the back. I want you to sing the chorus to Yellow Submarine, bitch, while I smoke weed on your leg. We all...
I'm playing the leg, I am. I'm playing the leg.
Hop around. Go ahead, hop around.
Hop around.
Hop around, love.
We'll go to break with Brother Joe.
She's laughing at you. Look at her. That's how the limey laughs.
Let's go to break with Brother Joe doing a little Lady McCartney song here.
Oh, yeah, this is brutal.
This is a classic. Are we getting mouse traps or what?
I hope so.
We better be.
We're going to have to clear this off. Holy shit.
Wow, we came up with a good idea during the break. What can
Kansas
I tell you?
Hand it over to her.
Hell yeah. Fucking no.
She got
Hell no.
It. She got
to learn
it.
A lesson in life.
This is a lot of money.
You got to pay for whatever you get.
What do we got? Why are they coming in?
Danny.
Dwayne Reed probably got some.
Wendy.
Danny and Fanny.
We need about 10 mousetraps.
10 would be good.
6, whatever.
We could reset them.
6 to 10 we need.
Authentic, regular, snapping mousetraps.
That's right.
Nothing fancy.
Like Tom and Jerry.
That's
yeah,
right.
Tom and Jerry's.
Classic. Acme mousetraps.
I got the bit.
All right.
I got it. It all came together.
A little more evilness is thrown
in. It all came together because we're like naked, dancing naked, mousetraps. Well, okay, here's the deal. We clear off the console here,
yep.
Right? We get Stalker Patty completely naked, okay?
All right.
Mousetraps all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
The check that the listeners are giving her through us.
Yes.
All right? Blindfolded, has to find.
that's brilliant.
Genius. That's
brilliant.
That's
Ladies it. And gentlemen.
All Thank
right.
you.
That's Greg Opie Hughes.
Yeah.
That's Greg coming Opie through.
Hughes. Thank you.
Genius. Coming through. Genius. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the shit. That should be on the message boards.
Thank you.
When the subject of what we do on the show,
Thank
how
you.
We all contribute.
This is why I'm here,
and,
yes.
I want a fucking
this
thread.
This is why makes the All-Star team is the point guard of the
started
league.
Started on what? Because that brings it all together.
Look, I'm not going to score 81 like Kobe, but I'm going to have a lot of assists
Jason
during
Kidd
that game.
Jason Kidd, that is brilliant.
Add
the check itself is part of the bait.
Right.
And now reaching down naked, yeah. Trying to find it amongst set mountains.
Does she have a time limit? A time limit? Or that's too evil?
Until she's fucking screaming in pain.
I'm just going to guess that it's going to be hidden really well.
Yes.
I'm just going to go out on a limb there and say it's going to be difficult to find.
Yes. Yes. This is what you could do on
Sunday. Oh,
radio.
Wow. That is brilliant.
Let's go to Kara in Texas. Kara.
It's Kira.
Kira.
Whoa.
Kira, hi. I was just calling to say I love you guys.
Oh, thanks.
But could you tell Patrice to shut the fuck up because
I knew it.
He's interrupting you.
I knew it.
Oh, no. You know, when there's a lot of guys in here, there's a lot of energy going on. I got to yell over people a little bit. Just to go in different
it's
directions.
Only
it's okay.
An
I sniffed it.
Dude.
Well, that means that these guys don't have low self-esteem, bitch. They'll tell me to shut up.
Yeah, no. We're
it's a conversation like guys have conversations when girls aren't around. You fucking bitch.
And quite frankly, I don't have much to say today.
That's how it works.
Opie just does it. You can't even see when Opie... This is the Opie... Patrice, shut up. It's a left hand in the air.
Yep.
And I'm getting ready to do what I just said I'm going to do.
Yeah.
And it all stops.
Right.
And I can hear it. Why did I hear it?
Because we do a lot of shows where we end up doing nothing.
Wait a minute. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever met a Kira in life who actually enjoyed you on any level?
Not on any fucking level. Dumb bitch.
What is your top 5 white girls cannot stand you?
Is it Karen?
Kara? Oh. Suzanne? This is Marilyn. Hi. Hi. My name is Doris. Hi.
Doris is a little older white woman.
Right.
Young one is.
But she don't like you.
My name is Kathy. My name is something Ann. Kimber Ann. Ethel Ann. Sarah Ann.
How about
hi.
Barbara's? Do you do all right with Barbara's?
Fuck you.
I don't think Heather would like you either.
I want to listen to.
I like
up.
Her.
Yeah.
I like her.
Ugh.
All right, here's the deal.
Yeah, I think she brought up some good points, Chase.
Yeah.
Why don't you shut
all,
the fuck up?
All fair points. And very true. I just wanted to curse her out.
Yeah. Did the boys run out to get the mousetraps?
Yeah.
We're running out of show
here. We're running out of show. We cannot run out of show before this happens.
Get the pit crew in here. We got to get the stage ready.
All right.
I want to dance on a stage.
Yeah, the stage needs to. Oh, well.
All right, the pit crew is coming
E-Rock.
In to get the stage
comes
ready.
And here Than.
Our own mayonnaise-filled E-Rock.
Yes.
Just oozing out of his pores.
E-Rock.
Hey, Maury.
Hellman's makes everything
Maury
better.
Is rerunning the Patty Show again today, by
Are
the
you
way.
Kidding?
They must have really loved that show. We could give Maury another show topic if he likes.
Well, this should be what Maury did with Patty. But
right.
Maury doesn't have that evil creativity that Opie has.
Let's get Stalker Patty in here to set this thing up, okay?
All right. Where's Patty?
Patty?
She's talking to David Hinckley.
Yeah.
For a little while, huh?
Thanks for wrecking our interview
that
with the Daily
great.
News.
You had to be the first person David talks to when he's going to do our interview today?
Hey, I...
The Daily News.
It was my pleasure to meet him. I've been reading his column for so many years.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Was he as thrilled to meet you as you were?
David Hinckley's thrilled in the other room,
yes.
By the way.
Jesus, Patty, you turned years into 18 syllables. How did that happen? Yeerers.
Yeerers. I read your curriculum for yeerers.
By the way, I like your show.
Thank you.
Oh.
It's wee-wee-bubba-junk.
Patty, you have cable?
Well, yeah, it comes with my
yeah,
brunch.
Hey,
with
Patty,
your pad, yeah.
Patty, you coming in Friday for American Mess? We want some of the past messes to come in and help us choose new messes for this show.
You know how they
sure.
bring in, like, old
no
winners
problem.
From American Idol
yeah.
to help out the new kids that are up
yeah.
and coming? We want you, as an old mess from the show, to come in
yeah.
and help out, give the kids some pointers.
We're finding new messes starting this Friday. It's an open call. It's called American Mess. It starts this Friday. You just show up at the station if you think you got something to yeah. offer to this program.
Does Patty know why she's here today?
No.
Oh,
he didn't
wow.
say. Usually
okay.
they tell me why, but this time
yeah,
they didn't.
Yeah, she has no clue. Patty,
this is your life.
What is the situation?
Oh,
you've been in a lot of bad situations over the years since we've known you, financially, mentally, I don't know, physically. We always are there for you when you're at your lowest point to try to help you out. No matter how badly it looks to some listeners that we're abusing you, we're there helping you along the way. We've
I
given you
my
temporary shelter in our studio stairwell.
Well, we had no choice in that because we made her leave her residence because the people that she was living with were trying to help her out.
Yeah.
And they said we were a bad influence on her and her life. And we told Patty to leave that residence.
Leave the house.
And she did.
Even though
she
had nowhere to go.
She became homeless.
Yeah, she became homeless.
And then started living under the stairs at the old radio station with her pet rabbit. Her stuffed pet rabbit.
Stuffed pet rabbit. Then there were your hammer toes. You had hammer toes. And we had them fixed up for you, didn't we?
Yes, you did.
Yes, we did.
They can fix that?
Two nice
yeah.
doctors on Long Island.
Exactly.
They...
Patty, when you had a problem with maybe some excessive hair that you wanted removed.
Nipple hair.
Who was there for you?
You were.
Opie and Anthony, we hired some Brazilian waxing people that came in and helped out with your nipple hair. When you were bald, suddenly for some reason bald.
Well, we shaved her head for
Oh,
money.
That's right. That was us. We shaved her head. when we shaved your head for and gave you two tickets and money, who gave you a wig?
You did.
We see, we help her out.
Yeah.
We're always there to help.
Who got
even though
you?
Opie tried to take the wig from her on the middle of the street.
Who got you a makeover on Maury Povich?
You did.
What? Right.
You
Maury
tried to take
makeover.
Her wig?
Dude.
Oh, it's the
Bill,
cruelest.
It's one of the most classic moments on the Opie and Anthony show.
Jesus.
I start screaming, take the wig, and she's screaming. It should be on OAVirus.com.
By the way, I'm not going to say what just came in. Is that it?
Yeah.
All right, that came in.
All right, we're
in
ready.
A bag. That, who went and got those?
Crazy Bill.
Crazy Bill in record time. Again, Bill,
one of the best interns
knowing
ever.
Exactly where to go to
knowing
get supplies.
Knowing where to go, what to get. Bang, bang, bang. Job is
We're
done.
We're trying to get him some money. Cause
he is a model intern.
He's just amazing. Amazing.
And a complete drugged out maniac, by the way. We love him.
We think.
We think. In my humble opinion.
Yeah. In my expert opinion.
Expert opinion.
He's going to be on A&E one day.
Yeah. You know, years ago he wrote, I want to hold your hand, but nowadays it's just the greatest, most eclectic stuff, I think.
All right.
Patty, you have no idea why you're here.
No.
You're in a little trouble, aren't you, right now?
Well, yeah.
Financially?
What's your latest trouble?
Well, my latest trouble is I 3 weeks ago, I lost my job. Because a new manager took over, we didn't get along, and
they fired you from Godiva?
Wait,
this is new to me.
She did, yeah.
I didn't know you now don't have a job.
Well, it's
last
okay.
I heard, wait.
Interviewing with Starbucks on the 31st, and I was told that that was a great company to go for.
All right,
for.
But last I heard.
You were a perfect employee for Godiva.
I know,
now
but what can
off.
I tell you? It's, you know, the
I don't drink
manager,
coffee.
So,
I like chocolate.
You know.
You do like free
chocolate.
You do like cakey.
Oh,
I just come on the radio and hype it.
Definitely.
Yeah.
You got fired from Godiva?
Well, yeah, but it was just the manager. I guess she didn't like me. It was a new manager. It was 100% crew turnover, practically. There's only one old person
left.
Yeah,
they like to bring in their own people.
They had a new company policy about using chapstick.
Oh! All right, we got to get going.
Patty, the problem, though, was before this is new to me that you lost your job, but before that, you were having a problem paying the rent.
Yes, I did.
And you got behind.
A little behind,
A little behind. How far is a little behind in your rent?
$2,000.
You're $2,000 deep in debt for rent on your place, and they're threatening to maybe remove you.
Well, not quite. I'm dealing with social services, and it's been delayed because I'm working with
it's
social
delayed,
services.
But now you don't have a job. So this is real trouble.
Well, I have unemployment. I'm getting $166 a week after I filed for it. So
you are a mess.
Well, the listeners took it upon themselves. They felt,
Patty,
they felt
listeners.
For you.
The listeners set something up and felt for you and wanted to help you out.
The O&A Pests.
The O&A Pests came up with money for you to pay your rent.
Oh,
Patty.
Oh, I got a call.
There is a grand total of, Opie, pull out the checks.
They had a fundraiser, Patty, and the O&A Pests, they do good as well as bad. They collected
$2,000. $2,000, Patty.
Oh, my God.
That they collected for you for the rent.
Now
here's
God.
The thing.
Now, if you know our show.
It would be so nice to just hand this over to you, right?
Has that ever happened, Patty?
Oh, the last time I was on the floor a year ago with a Krusty the Clown mask on, but that's not all. Just a little bit, naked.
You were completely naked, wearing nothing but a Krusty the Clown mask.
And every time I hear a worst of, that's one of the first things they
fire her. Now I understand why she got fired. You like the chocolate with the truffles and you're fired.
Those are one of my favorite sentences.
Could we have a mocha cappuccino over here? I need a T-E-T.
She refused to pronounce Godiva correctly.
We got to move forward, though, guys, or we're going to run
out of
time.
Yeah, we're running out of time, guys.
But basically, just a real quick setup for the new listener. She needed money. We collected the money. It was a pile on the floor. She got completely naked. She put on the Krusty the Clown mask, crawled to the money, and voila, she got the money.
Yeah,
well, we came up with something for today's $2,000. Last time we gave you money, how much was it when you were naked crawling?
$700.
Yeah, $700.
Because I sold that. Something or whatever.
Wait, I'm getting a communique from
Than is saying something.
But, right,
so it's
right,
either right. It's either very necessary information or just sarcastic bullshit.
So for $2,000, we can't just hand it over to you.
No,
We have to entertain these people across America, and we're going to use you to entertain them.
Than, genius on a post-it.
Jesus Christ, Than, how does it start?
Can you say
it was a bright summer day. Here
was the
on
best of times.
It was the worst of times.
Of Fan and Min.
Yeah, Fan. Jesus. What's this, a three post-it note? Urgent communique.
Oh, okay. All right, can we...
Let me see.
No!
I get it, too.
He's like a little 8-year-old. I want to see it, Joe.
That's all. Did you have to use the word incredibly when you're writing a quick fucking note?
All right, here we go.
Incredibly.
So we got $2,000 for you, Patty.
Mm-hmm.
Trust me. We don't want to see it, but it's going to make for a good video clip on the website. Yeah. You're going to get completely naked.
Patty, nudity is involved again.
$2,000, Patty.
$2,000.
All your problems are washed away.
Here it is.
After a couple minutes of humiliation.
Problem solved.
We got $2,000. You see how we cleared off the area in front of us? You're going to be naked in front of us, okay?
Patty, center stage. Center you are going to be.
Oh, they're pulling the curtain.
We're completely naked.
We're going to lay the checks in front of you somewhere. Should we do this on the floor so she has more room to move around? Yeah, we should do it. We're going to do it on the floor, okay? So you have more room to move around. The checks will be on the floor. You'll be naked. You'll also, unfortunately, be blindfolded, Patty.
Patty, you will be blindfolded. Now, the check will be somewhere down there. You just have to find it by searching around and trying to find it.
It's like the treasure hunt.
Sounds easy, right? Okay. You're just going to be crawling around on the floor trying to find the check that's on the floor. Easy enough, right?
Yeah.
And that $2,000 will be yours. You think it'll take a little while as you're blindfolded to find it?
Most likely.
Most likely. But once you feel a couple of pieces of paper, you know it's the check, and you know you have $2,000.
Yes.
It's that easy, Patty.
Do I put it in my hoochie-coochie?
No hoochie-coochie involved. Does that sound easy enough? Are you willing to give it a try? Everybody, she's willing to give it a try. Patty, there's one thing I forgot to tell you. Sam, why don't you give me that bag? Jeez. You know, whenever anybody asked for a Johnny to bring down the little thing, it was always there. Patty, we have a bag full of these.
What are they?
These are mouse traps.
No!
These are going to be all over the floor. And
but
as you go
to... get stuck in one?
Well, then you're going to have to move on because that ain't the check.
You gotta chew your hand off like a bear.
Those things break rats' necks.
I know. Watch this. Ow! I will admit it hurts like a motherfucker, but I'm fine.
See,
I wouldn't be willing to do anything. I would be willing to.
You could do it.
That's bullshit.
Ah,
that's
whatever.
From his 20 years of putting air conditioners in. He can't even feel his hands anymore. He's got those blue-collar calluses.
You couldn't have just gotten the regular ones. These are Tomcats. This hurts so bad. My finger is ready to come off.
That's an industrial rat trap. That is for New York rats.
Patty, we're going to snap it on your finger.
That's a badger trap.
Yeah, that's not fucking Greenwich mice. That's for dogs. They catch deer. Oh, they're going to kill poor
Patty.
Wait, what do you do?
You don't need to set it.
Man, I don't know.
Do it.
Do your.
I'm not fucking doing
it. Do your
it.
Whole finger in there.
It's gonna hurt.
Yeah, the more meat you get in there.
Yeah, get a lot of meat.
Hurt.
Get the meat between your thumb and forefinger.
Do it.
Just
hit
it.
Do it. Just hit it.
Yourself.
Come on, Opie.
All right. The traps work. Bill want to do it?
I got to do it.
All right, let Bill Bird do it.
I got to do it.
Opie, you
fucking crazy white boy. This is crazy. I got to know what it feels like. It's going to make me enjoy it more.
I'm just showing you.
How do you set it?
Yeah, help him set it before he...
Set it and forget it.
It's middle-aged jackass.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, man, does that
wow.
hurt.
That leaves a
we're
mark.
We're doing the newspaper game with those stupid...
Whatever. We're just showing you if we could do it,
you don't think about it. You just got to do it.
Yeah, let's go.
Yeah.
All right, we got to set these traps. How many we got, by the way?
What are you doing? Don't you know how to set a mouse trap?
Here, give it to me. I'll set it.
Steve?
What?
Against traps because once he was caught in one out into the woods of Jersey.
I bet if it was an electric trap, he'd know how to use it.
Nothing.
All right. Yeah. Anything?
You know, right, Opie, if you got
there you go.
Yourself a cat,
okay. Shut up.
You would never have a
all right, here we go. Here we go.
Here it is.
Ah, you motherfucker!
That hurts, man. That really hurts.
Come on, Patrice. One time.
Look at you.
You got the big meaty hands.
Yeah,
it's not gonna Patrice.
I'm not adventurous, motherfucker.
Ain't gonna hurt
Why
you.
Why don't next week we wrestle rhinos, motherfucker?
You comparing wrestling rhinos to this?
That, fuck you. That hurts. I'm not gonna call them.
All right,
Patty. What we need you to do is leave the studio. Where's she gonna get naked?
Well, it's got to be in here.
My hand is shaking.
Got to be. Yeah.
All right. Makes the hand. Well, what do you want to do?
Yeah.
What are they saying?
Let her get...
Turn her around. And
there's a mic somewhere because I'm picking up somebody.
Let her get up here.
Oh, all right.
Let her get up here and do a little striptease.
No, I don't want to see that.
She got, well,
smart.
You know something,
really
Opie?
Smart.
The people want to see it.
Oh, okay.
The people want to see it.
All right. Yeah, we are on Pal Talk.
All right, Patty.
Smart.
Give her a little help up. Give her a boost up.
All right, let's see your naked turnip body.
And,
naked
turnip.
You have a turn-up figure.
Do you have any strip music?
Instead of an... Ugh.
And ladies, come on up. Come on, fellas.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up to the stage right now, you might remember her as one of the Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders. Her name is Heather. Let's give her a big hand as she comes up. It's a Stalker Patty, everybody. Big hand for Stalker Patty.
All right, Patty, can you hear it? Come on, fellas, the more you clap, the more she's going to do.
Well, wow, no one's clapping. Big surprise
right.
There.
All right, Patty, now in as sexy a fashion as you can,
remove your awful clothing.
Yeah, take off your awful clothes. All right. Oh, lips and hips.
Ugh.
All right, she's taking her. When strippers do it, it's so much sexier.
Oh, she's got a hole in her sock.
Patty's got a hole in her sock, and a big long toenail is sticking through it.
I was 40. This is fucking shocking.
Her big long toenail. Patty, you should have clipped your toenails.
Yeah.
Well,
should have burned those socks.
All right, get rid of the socks.
Are those an actual color?
Yeah,
those
they were white.
I thought
white
those
socks.
Hammer toes were fixed.
They're growing back.
Oh, they came back as wrench toes, monkey wrench toes.
Right.
It's a different tool.
All right,
Patty. Here she goes.
Oh, did you see her pathetically just try to wiggle a little bit as a stripper? Oh,
Oh my God. What, did the cat scratch you?
Well, as he does the rest with me.
There we go. Yeah. This is one of these shows, like, when I leave, I feel like I left a part of me here.
Yeah.
Part of my soul is gone.
Because you did.
And all right. Oh, she's wearing Opie and Anthony, an Opie and Anthony thong. How did you know to wear that thong?
She wears it every day.
I just put it on because it was clean underwear.
Ladies and gentlemen, how old are you, Patty?
50.
She's 50 years old. Hey, does Oxy make one of those pads for your ass? Why, what's the matter? Patty, do a little spin for the crowd here. All right. All right. Well, Patty, you're going to have to do the money shot now, and the O&A thong has to go.
No,
here we go.
She can keep that on.
Oh, I'm the bad guy now. I just said it before you did. I want to get off. Make it stop.
Hey.
Oh. Wow.
You look like you should be in Lord of the Rings.
I'm thinking about Schindler's List.
Now,
don't worry about covering up. Feel good about yourself.
Oh, my God.
Are the mousetraps being set? They are?
All right, she can step down so we get the freaking blindfold
right, there
on.
There we go. Patty, step down.
Oh,
Jesus. Wow, I saw a little not looking. I think
Patrice,
away.
There it is.
Hi, Patty.
Look, it's the prize in the community, the white woman, naked. Isn't that the prize?
She'd be pit bull training.
Just in case. Just in case you were wondering what Getty Lee looks like naked.
Oh,
is that it?
lead singer.
Fuck,
Rush.
Thank you.
I'm Gadina.
All right, we need a blindfold.
All right,
so.
If we can get a blindfold of who just got nailed with a mousetrap?
One of the interns.
Oh, that hurts like a motherfucker, doesn't it? Are you okay?
No.
No, man, I'm pretty fucking far from okay.
Did you see how far that thing flew?
Dude, we're running out of show, believe it or not.
Yeah, we're running out of show. This. Oh,
Jesus.
All right, the mousetraps are being set. Patty needs a blindfold.
Yeah, let's get the blindfold on Patty.
Patty, I hope you are ready for a little bit of pain because those traps hurt really bad. I am really bruised here.
Christ. You just can't help not looking right at it.
It really is like a murder scene.
She looks like somebody stuck a firecracker up there.
I think for 50, that's fine.
Yeah, it is. And it's virgin, you know, right? It's a virgin toucher.
And she's a virgin. So she's untouched by...
For 50.
Untouched by a man. Or woman or anything. As far as I know.
This is like when you're on the subway platform.
There's peanut butter and a cat, but... Right. Yes.
Trap set.
It's like when you're on the subway platform, you're just praying for the train to come. If some homeless person begins to disrobe, you're like, oh, please.
Come on, where is it?
Her hymen please. Looks like tapioca. Untouched hymen that grows old.
Stop. It's not even pliable anymore. It's like stained glass.
Stained glass hymen. It's
petrified.
Shattered.
She has a petrified hymen.
It's like a Lay's potato chip now.
Hyman's like a sack of marbles.
I think this is going to top the Krusty the Clown mask.
Well, Patty, I got to agree with
Jesus
you there.
Jesus Christ, this looks like one of those terrorist videos.
Oh, it does. It looks like she's going to be killed.
And wouldn't it be better to end that way? By just maybe chopping her head off. But, Patty, your head is safe. Don't worry.
Oh, my God. Why didn't you bring in one of your swords? You should have been standing
I could have decapitated her. That would have been... Right.
Make her read a letter.
And she's rocking back and forth.
Yeah, make her hold a newspaper.
America is no good, and you should not be here, and it's not good.
I want to appeal to my family.
Oh,
you got nailed again?
I'm trying to set the trap.
Yeah, they're hard. I want
Please
to appeal
to... get out of Iraq.
You know, America
Remove
is...
Remove the troops.
We're being criminals here, and we really should leave.
We only got 5 minutes left.
5 minutes. How many traps are we setting?
About 10, and I'm...
Oh, shit.
And I'm
getting,
10? I'm getting the checks in place, too.
All right. The checks are going to be...
Jesus, Opie is hands-on, motherfucker.
You're not putting the checks in the trap, are you?
I'm not.
That would be cruel.
Oh, God.
The checks are going in the trap.
All right. Get Patty over
Ladies
there.
That looks like a field
the
in Vietnam.
Are in the trap. Yeah, it's the killing field.
Oh, what is it? That picture of the naked baby running down the street?
Yeah, yo! After the napalm strike went bad, we hit the village. That's what Patty looked like, that little naked Vietnamese
girl.
Where is she now? All right, I'm...
Still got the scars on her back. Oh,
get Patty up against the door.
Oh, all right.
I gotta go to church.
God.
I'm going to church this week.
I'm
going to
be the field reporter here.
Oh, this is so bad.
And if you could grab my mic over there, you might have a better view. All right,
I can see from here.
Get her on all fours. Oh, Jesus. Patty, here's the deal. You hear my voice?
Shit.
Yeah, I do.
All right, you
got to
come toward me. There's 10 mouse traps in front of you.
And
she allowed to curl her fingers up like that.
And two.
Yeah, she could do whatever she
wants.
You
got to feel around for the checks as you move forward, okay?
Oh, I'm so scared.
Yes, but just think of the wonderful prizes you're going to win at the end of this.
$2,000, Patty.
Oh, no.
No, don't do that!
$2,000, Patty.
No.
Come on.
Oh, no, God.
Oh, my God.
What was it?
Okay, that was.
Don't move.
That was not the check.
Oh, this is so.
Obviously not. It's
scary. For the check, Patty.
We're almost there.
$2,000 on the...
Oh, my God. That hit me. Wow. My finger.
That's what it's supposed to do.
Hey, if you were a mouse, you'd be dead. Come on, keep crawling.
Come on, old mouse.
By the way, huh? You think mice get $2,000 at the end of this? They don't.
By the way, if you don't find the checks by the end of the show, then they stay on the floor until tomorrow.
Oh, my God, with the back of the hand.
Oh, my God.
It just got the palm of my hand.
She's going to have to give the teller to check with a mouse.
Well, you're mean.
Patty, we're running out of show.
Come on, Patty, run out of show.
Hurt.
All
Come
your
on,
problems could go away.
I felt a piece of paper. Do I have a check? I think
oh,
I do.
You just got $1,000.
Yeah, there it is. One check.
One check. One to go. One to go.
$1,000.
Oh! Ow!
Ow! I break all my knuckles. I take it. My palm, my knuckles.
Fuck, man, I can't
oh,
even take
God,
it.
Oh, my God.
How much time, Derek?
Oh, Patty.
A minute 30?
Oh.
Oh, Patty.
I don't know.
Just slap the floor. Just get it over with.
Ow! Did you do that on purpose?
No.
No, we wouldn't do
no,
that.
No, none of
ow,
this.
Ow, ow, ow!
Three of them.
Oh, come on, Opie. This is not funny.
I'm almost
you
forgetting she's
that
naked.
You push me and you know it.
Ow.
You pushed that toward me. I know you did.
She thinks she's ow.
How much time, Derek? All right, we got a minute left, Patty. You got to find the check in a minute. Hey, don't touch me.
This well, is all being videotaped.
Opie, you pushed that toward me, too.
All being videotaped, so don't worry.
I'm
you'll get to see
I'm starting to recognize his anger.
Yeah.
I'm having a Bernie Getz flashback here.
Yep. I feel it.
That's my foot. Move away from me. It's back this way, actually. It's back this way.
What is wrong with you?
Find it?
No, she's still looking. It's behind you, Patty, I swear. Ah!
It hurt.
Hurry, it's 30 seconds left in the show. It's behind
seconds
you.
In the show. Come on.
Behind you. It's behind you. Oh, my God.
I found it.
She found
hey,
it.
We have a winner. $2,000, Patty. Congratulations.
Oh, God. I can walk now. My palm hurt. Holy, how many were there? No wonder I'm from my
we reset a few.
Yeah.